Let's see how we can find the tangential component and the normal component for the acceleration. And here we want the t to be 2. So here we have our curve. Let's just go ahead and recall that at is equal to the derivative with respect to t of the speed. In other words, the magnitude of the velocity. And then for an, this right here is equal to the square root. We would need to get the magnitude of the acceleration squared and then minus whatever that is, that's at, and then we square that. So let's just go ahead and get to work. First, we need to get the velocity. Just take the derivative of this with respect to t. So put a 3 to the front minus 1, 3 and 3 cancel, so we get t squared I. And then take the derivative, put a 2 to the front minus 1, 2 and 2 cancel, so just t and then j. So that's the velocity. Next, we need the magnitude. So the magnitude of the velocity is just going to be the square root. We square the first component and then we add it with the square of the second component. So that is square root of t to the fourth plus t squared. Then we are going to have at, which will just take the derivative of our speed. So that's the derivative of this thing, square root of t to the fourth power plus t squared. So work that out, we are going to get something over 2 square root of t to the fourth plus t squared. And then use the chain rule, multiply by the derivative of this inside, right? So 4t to the third power plus 2t. We can actually simplify this. Here we can factor out t squared. So we get t squared times t squared plus 1 in the square root. So square the first and square the second because it's just a product. Now, because we want when t is equal to 2, of course that's greater than 0. So when we cancel the square root and the square, we can just have t. You don't have to worry about the absolute value. So we have t, and this is the square root of t squared plus 1. Now we can cancel out this t and this and that. That's quite nice. And then we can also cancel 2 with this 2, and also the 4 will become a 2. So it's just the algebra and all that stuff. And we will end up with 2. T squared plus 1 over that square root of t squared plus 1. And because we want when t is equal to 2, so I will write down at t equals 2, at will be plugging 2 in here, 2 squared is 4 times 2 is 8 plus 1 is 9, over plugging 2 in here, 2 squared is 4 plus 1 is 5 in the square root. So that's what at is. Next, we are going to work out an. Notice we need to have the acceleration. So I'm going to look at this and then just take the derivative. So the acceleration will be the derivative of this, which is 2t, and then we have the I, plus the derivative of that, which is going to be 1, and then we have the j. And in fact, we just need to work out a number, right? So I'm not going to, you know, work with expressions, because for a of t, we can just put this right here, right? So I just have to plug in 2 into all the t's. So I will write that as a of 2. 2 times 2 is 4, and then we have the I, and then plus 1j. All right. Let's go ahead and get the magnitude of it. So the magnitude of a at 2 is equal to the square root of 4 squared plus 1 squared. And that will give us square root of 17. So as you can see, that will be a number. This is a number that we come from here. So an, when t is equal to 2, right, let me just denote that, we will get square root. Put the magnitude here, that's square root of 17, square that, minus AT, which is 9 over square root of 5. Square that. Okay, this is 17 minus this is 81 over 5. Get the common denominator, multiply 5 and 5. So that's 85 over 5 minus 81 over 5. So it's 85 over minus 81 over 5. That's 4 over 5. And then, of course, we still have the square root. So this is equal to square root of 4 is 2, and then square root of 5 is just square root of 5. Just like this. So we are pretty much done. AT is equal to 9 over square root of 5, and AN is equal to 2 over square root of 5. But remember, we have done a video on finding the unit tangent factor and also the unit normal factor for this curve at exactly the same time. Let's construct it now. At t equals 2, we know we can write our acceleration as the tangential component at times the unit tangent factor plus an, the normal component, and then we multiply that with the unit normal factor. What this is really saying is that we can write A as a linear combination of T and N. It just means that it's a scalar or a constant multiple with T, and we add it with another constant times N. Here, at T is equal to 2, A is equal to this. 4i plus 1j. And that's equal to AT, which is that, 9 over square root of 5. And T, from last time, I plus, put 2 in here, we have 1 over square root of 5j. So this right here, we'll do it. An is this, which is 2 over square root of 5. And N from last time, all right. So T and N. Just real quick, if you multiply this and that, you will see this is 18 over 5. If you multiply this and that, this is 2 over 5. This plus that is 20 over 5, which we get 4. And then if you multiply this and that, we get 9 over 5. This times that is negative 4 over 5. 9 over 5 minus 4 over 5 is 5 over 5, which is 1. So this right here, we get the I component. Combine it with the J component, and that's how you break down the acceleration, just like that.